Welcome to you through the door. Each of us came through the door today. 3 years ago, we couldn't. I'll reflect on that a bit further in today's message. In the order of service, we are divine service four, the service of the word, divine setting four, service of the word. And I will be leading the music today. So there are some points you'll just have to give it a prayerful pause, I guess, while I exchange between the guitar and otherwise. So may God bless us in his house today in worship. The opening hymn, what is it, 973? Thy word is a lamp to my feet. Please stand as you're able. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Who made heaven and earth.
If you, O Lord, kept a record of sins, O Lord, who could stand?
I believe there is forgiveness, therefore you are feared.
Since we are gathered to hear God's word of salvation in the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ and call upon him in prayer and praise, let us first consider our unworthiness and confess before God and one another that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and that we cannot free ourselves from our sinful condition. Together, as his people, let us take refuge in the infinite mercy of God, our Heavenly Father, seeking his grace for the sake of Christ and saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner.
All right.
merciful Father, in holy baptism you declared us to be your children and gathered us into your one holy church, in which you daily and richly forgive us our sins and grant us new life through your Spirit. Be in our midst, enliven our faith, and graciously receive our prayer and praise through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
I am the Good Shepherd.
I know my own, and my own know me, and I lay down my life for the sheep.
O come, let us sing to the Lord.
Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation.
Let us come into his presence with thanksgiving.
Let us make a joyful noise to him with songs of praise.
For the Lord is a great God,
and a great King above all gods.
O come, let us worship and bow down.
Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker.
For he is our God,
and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. I am the Good Shepherd.
I know my own, and my own know me, and I lay down my life for the sheep.
Since you have wakened from death the shepherd of your sheep, grant us your Holy Spirit, that when we hear the voice of our shepherd, we may know him who calls us each by name and follow where he leads. Through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated. The first reading is according to Acts chapter 2, 42 through 47. This follows the preaching of St. Peter on the day of Pentecost. And they devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, to the breaking of bread and the prayers. And awe came upon every soul, And many wonders and signs were being done through the apostles. And all who believed were together and had all things in common. And they were selling their possessions and belongings and distributing the proceeds to all, as any had need. And day by day, attending the temple together and breaking bread in their homes, they received their food with glad and generous hearts, praising God and having favor with all the people. And the Lord added to their number day by day those who were being saved. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We continue with the gradual hymn, "The Lord's My Shepherd, I'll Not Want."
The Lord's my shepherd, I'll not want. He makes me down to lie in pastures green.
The epistle reading is according to 1 Peter chapter 2, 19 through 25. For this is a gracious thing when, mindful of God, one endures sorrows while suffering unjustly. For what credit is it if, when you sin and are beaten for it, you endure? But if, when you do good and suffer for it, you endure, this is a gracious thing in the sight of God. For to this you have been called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example, so that you might follow in his steps. He committed no sin, neither was deceit found in his mouth. When he was reviled, he did not revile in return. When he suffered, he did not threaten, but continued entrusting himself to him who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in his body on the tree, that we might die to sin and live to righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed. For you were straying like sheep, but have now returned to the shepherd and overseer of your souls. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Gospel Anthem, 740, I Am Jesus' Little Lamb. Hallelujah. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. Hallelujah. I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me. Hallelujah. According to John chapter 10, reading verses 1 through 10 on this, what is known as Good Shepherd Sunday. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said, "Truly, truly, I say to you, he who does not enter the sheepfold by the door, but climbs in by another way, that man is a thief and a robber. But he who enters by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him the gatekeeper opens. The sheep hear his voice, and he calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. A stranger they will not follow, but they will flee from him, for they do not know the voice of strangers." This figure of speech Jesus used with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them. So Jesus again said to them, "Truly, truly, I say to you, I am the door of the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved and will go in and out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please be seated. The hymn of the day, 709. The King of Love, my shepherd is.
I know nothing wrong.
enter by the door. Are you entering by the door? 3 years ago, it was ironic how for the seventh week and counting of public health restrictions due to the COVID-19 pandemic, we were not free to enter many doors. That included our doors to worship here at Redeemer. A time to reopen the doors was unknown. We were bound by travel restrictions. Stay at home, keep your distance, wash your hands frequently. Smaller businesses not considered essential services were closed. We missed being able to access various personal care services like haircutting and styling, massage therapy, elective dentistry. Many clinical contacts were only by phone or internet. Restaurants could offer curbside or takeout delivery only. That imposed separation amplified the yearning and, for some groups, the demand for freedom, for unrestricted group activities. Major sports, music concerts, entertainment venues, air transportation hubs, gatherings of larger numbers of people, including Sunday public worship services. Many were the doors closed. And we didn't know for how long. There was a growing sense of need within us to connect, to be in touch, to share time and contact and space with other living human beings. How it underscored, some things of life simply can't happen without entering the door. Now we're free again. We had to endure, I believe it was 2 multi-month waves of COVID closures. Doors remain essential. Think of it. Houses, stores, shops, restaurants, barns, garages, fenced areas, ballparks, tennis courts, ski lifts. There's a door, a gate, an opening. Even cars, pickups, trucks, and buses. Doors control passage, seeking to give access to desirable and necessary things, to give security and protection. Doors even help manage climate control, to help keep us dry and warm in winter or cool in summer from the extremes of weather. We are finally again free. 3 years later, to enter basically anywhere, including seniors' residences, freely, by their doors, and even without a required mask. Yes, it remains a blessing and protection to enter shelter, to enter places of safety and rest, to enter our homes by a door. I am the door. Think of it. Hear what Jesus has said. How direct and plain is Jesus' claim? And yet, it's also veiled, a hidden saying of Jesus. Most all who heard him speak it didn't get it. The man born blind who now could see did believe in Jesus, and he was there. So were Jesus' disciples. But so also were the skeptical Pharisees and Sadducees who ever stood as adversaries to Jesus. They challenged everything about him. They believed they could certainly see that they knew best about God and religious truths. But Jesus declared they were blind spiritually, such that they were guilty of sin, of rejection of God's will. They were guilty of rejecting him as God's Son, their Messiah. They held no faith in God's word being fulfilled. Their guilt remained. They thought they knew what the right rules and concepts and beliefs were all about. But they didn't understand him. They did not believe him. So Jesus gives them and us and all who hear and study his word this figure of speech we are hearing today in his word, in the gospel. And so doing, Jesus asserts an amazing and most wonderful truth, the truth of what exists through the door. When it comes to spiritual life, a spiritual life with a future, Jesus has good news. He has purpose for all to enter through the door, through him. And in him, the results are life not merely counted in years and in the possession of things, but in eternity, in living communication and dwelling with our almighty and infinite, gracious and loving Creator. Oh, with God, Jesus said, is such an abundant life. Enter by the door. Are you entering by the door? Thieves and robbers don't. They employ devious ways, no good for those who reside inside. Jesus outlines their selfish ambitions and whims. The thief breaks in to steal, to kill, to destroy. That's the contrast of the ones who do not enter by the door. We picture them smashing a window, jimmying the lock, tying a chain to the doorpost and getting in the vehicle and yanking it out, all to get inside, to scrounge for money, or to intimidate people, perhaps to get revenge, or even carry out an assassination. Our world weeps. Violence in Sudan, Haiti, and Honduras. Fighting and destruction in Ukraine, launched by Russian ambition. Warlike conditions in Israel and Palestine. 3 years ago, as COVID dominated the news, its position as lead story, you might recall, was finally replaced by the terrible news of Canada's greatest mass shooting. We mourn the victims of those events in Nova Scotia in April of 2020, when that rampaging gunman, that police impersonator, killed and destroyed 22 lives and wounded three more in premeditated murder and destruction. RCMP police security and performance review now details changes needed to avoid repeating poor response to such rampage. How painful and too frequent are the times in our world when killers break in unwanted into lives and hurt and kill and destroy. The door to life in the person of Jesus, the Son of God, the Messiah, bids us to enter life by him, the door. His word speaks his desire and love and care for us for every day. Matthew 6 on his Sermon on the Mount, do not lay up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust destroy and where thieves break in and steal, but lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust destroys and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. Do you enter by the door? Why not? the treasures of Scripture or the reveals your and my reality. We are like sheep without a shepherd, wandering, lost, straying, thirsting, starving. We are caught, vulnerable. We die. And we're fooled. We listen to the stranger's voice. We get misled. Apart from Christ, we face eternal death, the punishment, just punishment, of Almighty God's wrath against our sins in fiery torment. Enter by the door. The shepherd does, and he calls the sheep by name. They recognize their shepherd, and they follow him. Enter by the door. Jesus does. His voice speaks the truth. He calls to you, teaching and proclaiming, repent, turn from your sins, wayward ways, disbelief. Surrender your burdens, cares, worries. Give them to me. Take my yoke. Trade your Lord, your load for mine. I give you rest. I give you the life forgiven, your guilt removed by my sacrifice, laying down my life for you. I give you the life which is abundant, spiritually alive. In me, you are a new creation. Jesus is the door to eternal life. Easter joy, Easter hope, Easter victory are all focused on him. In me, you are a new creation. He, the good shepherd, enter by the door. His sheep do, by following him, by hearing his under-shepherds, who are true and point to him. By listening to, heeding, delighting in, and following his voice. By treasuring his word that reveals God's grace for faith in Jesus Christ alone. Enter by the door. His sheep do by baptism. Holy baptism, his calling you by name, washing you, cleansing you, forgiving you. By baptism, which unites you in his death to put your old self to death. By baptism, which begets in you his new creation, which unites you with him in his resurrection. Enter by the door. His sheep do by his holy supper, where Jesus, the crucified Christ, gives you his very body and blood, by which he forgives you your sins, where Jesus proclaims his atoning death until he, the risen and ascended Lord, comes in power and glory. Jesus is the door to eternal life. He has come to save. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved. If anyone enters by me, that one is free through me to come and go and find pasture. Faithful under-shepherds, pastors who truthfully point to and use the door, Jesus, so are caring for their sheep, his flock. So they follow, the sheep do. They listen to the truth and are saved in Jesus. They enter through the door. Following him, they lead others to the door. Enter by Jesus. hear his voice, and you are following the shepherd of life. Do you? Are you entering by the door? Enter by the door. Place your faith anew in Jesus, the good shepherd, who laid down his life, crucified, who entered death to break through it for you, who rose again, lives and reigns today and always. The door to life abundant and eternal is this one, Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world. Praise be to the name, to his name, we are welcomed into his kingdom forever. This worship service then continues with the prayer of the church. Loving Father, your Son is the great shepherd of the sheep who faithfully gathers his flock to himself in the pastures of the church. Grant us steadfast faith to hear his voice and follow him, even through the valley of the shadow of death, that we may receive our portion in his abundant life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Holy Father, by the work of your Spirit, through the means of grace, you daily add to the number of believers. Grant your people courageous hearts and bold tongues to proclaim your truth, trusting that you will gather more in keeping with your gracious will. Bless BC Mission Boat with provision and its work in your name among the indigenous communities it serves. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Shepherd of Israel, you have clothed us with Christ's righteousness and taught us to love all that is good, beautiful, and true. Bless all artists and artisans, composers and musicians, and craftsmen and writers, that they may employ all their skills for your glory and in the service to the gospel, in service to the gospel, testify to your saving death and resurrection. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Almighty God, you hold in your hands all the might of man, and you hold accountable those who would govern your people. Grant to us good government and leaders who will honor your purpose, protect your people, serve the cause of justice, and defend our liberty. Lord, we pray, bring the end soon to quell the aggression and fighting by Russia in Ukraine, in Israel and Palestine, Haiti and Honduras, and grant the peace of your kingdom in Jesus Christ to come among them. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Merciful Shepherd, your wounds are our healing, and your voice our certainty. Hear us on behalf of those who suffer in body or mind, who grieve, or to whom death draws near. We pray especially for Myrna, that you would bless her treatments against cancer, for Gabrielle, her husband. For Shirley, peace, hope, and cheer for this upcoming week. Val, Richard, Renee, Brad, Joyce, and her daughter Ginger, Audrey, Elsie and family, including Francis and Jerry, Chris and Sarah, Aaliyah and Oliver, also the families of grandchildren David and Holly, Emily and Darlene, Phyllis, Fern, Bill and Twyla and Matt, Linda and Lee, Judy, Marg, Marjorie and son Drew, Rita T, Howard and Hannah, Jack and Rita, Carol and Martin, celebrating their marriage anniversary Wednesday, Reinhold, Pastor Les, Randy and Gail, Heinz, Audrey M, praise for birth of Jack Theodore, son of Pastor Andrew and Rachel, Lord of Life, Kamloops, this past Thursday, for Eva with family in Ontario, and pastor, and son Simon, and mothers Vienna and Lorraine. For Deanna and John, an extended family who grieved the loss of Egon Russell, whose funeral was held here Friday. and these also whom we name now. For survivors in Syria and Turkey, recovering physically and emotionally in their land destroyed by earthquake. For all those worldwide living with chronic illness, long COVID, depression, anxiety, and terminal disease. Grant them healing according to your will, grace to sustain them in trouble, and the sure hope of everlasting life. Abide also with the unemployed and the distraught. Return them to health and livelihood, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, in the wake of your Son's resurrection, your people devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, to the breaking of bread, and to the prayers. Unite your people in the one true faith, and grant penitent hearts that receive your sacrament of the altar in faith each time we receive your gift for our forgiveness and life. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, as you have put our sins to death in Christ's body on the tree, so bring life to our faith by his Spirit, that in your continual grace we may bring forth the fruit of holy lives. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
All these things and whatever else you know that we need, grant us, Father, for the sake of him who died and rose again and now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever.
Amen. Amen.
Peace of the Lord Jesus, attend and abide with you always. Our service then continues with the offering hymn 770, What a Friend We Have in Jesus.
Sins and gifts to bear. us of our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. All may join also in the collect for the church. Almighty God, grant to your church your Holy Spirit, and the wisdom that comes down from above, that your word may not be bound, but have free course, and be preached to the joy and edifying of Christ's holy people, that in steadfast faith we may serve you, and in the confession of your name abide to the end, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen.
You may be seated as worship continues with our concluding hymn, Let Us Ever Walk with Jesus, 685.
Sinners, there is one.
God's peace and blessing be with you. Praise God for our door to the abundant life. The best is ahead. And to think that even through death, he broke death to give us that life ahead. Just wait and see. It'll be wonderful.
The Lord is my shepherd.